Hello there. We, humans, may call it a natural disaster, but it really is an event of a very natural process of our planet Earth, since it comes with tremendous loss in many forms like life, wealth, and property. It always turns out to be disastrous to the inhabitants of this Earth, including us. Welcome to Indianistic, presented by me, Geeta. In this video, let us look at 15 of the deadliest types of natural disasters, along with some tips on how to survive them. I will refrain from ranking these disasters, but to give a structure to our top 15 list, I have considered the geographical impact that one disaster could make. Now, let's dive right into our top 15 types of natural disasters list. 15. Solar flares. A solar flare is a sudden burst of flashing brightness on the sun. When this happens along with coronal ejection and electromagnetic radiation, it results in a solar storm. While solar flares happen often, some are stronger and more severe, and these affect our radio communications and satellites. This radiation is also harmful to the skin of those on Earth, especially our astronauts who are out there. Though not usually life-threatening, let us see what we can do when the sun flares. Once a solar flare ejects, usually it takes days to reach Earth, so you will have ample time to know. While there is not much to be done, it is a must to apply a sunscreen while stepping out and be mindful of the excess heat. Avoid stepping out when it is too hot once a solar flare warning is issued. Usually, unless your life depends on continuous radio communication, you should be alright. 14. Landslides. As the name self-explains, landslide is when a massive piece of rock or earth collapses from a mountain or cliff. This often happens so sudden without any warning that the destruction it leaves is often very high. Landslides also often occur due to being triggered by any of the other natural calamities or rains or even human intervention. So things to do when a landslides. Get out of the affected area as fast as you can because more could be coming. Landslides usually are recurrences and don't stop with just one. Listen carefully for any creaks or other unusual sounds. Moving debris reaches you faster than you think, so when in doubt, run to a safer location than wait and see. Look out for flooding and help yourself and others to a safer area should the area flood because of some connected damage. If the landslide occurred near a water stream, avoid driving over the bridge or adjacent to the mountain. 13. Avalanche. Similar to landslides, avalanches occur when slabs of snow slide down a steep slope. At Mount Alps during World War I, a deadly avalanche killed nearly 80,000 soldiers. Understandably, these commonly occur on snowy mountains. So, things to do. While most of the rescue steps for landslides do apply here, it is important to remember to escape to the side of the avalanche. Just keep rolling like a log towards the other side. Grab whatever you can hold on to, a tree, a rock, or a bush. You won't get buried that way. Worst case, if you are being buried in snow, try to get one of your hands in front of the face to be able to breathe and the other one as high as possible so that you can try and dig yourself out once the avalanche stops. Very few people would die in avalanche if it is easy to get out and survive, but it is not. So the best thing to do is take all the necessary precautions and be alert. 12. Tornadoes. Tornado is what makes a cloud and the ground connected, but not for good reasons. This funnel-shaped calamity wipes out everything that comes its way, irrespective of how heavy or strong that object is. With speedy winds, tornadoes are capable of traveling for miles. If a tornado forms over a water body and not ground, it is called a water spout. So, what to do? Reach a sturdy building and stay in. Do not try to outrun the tornado in your vehicle. Importantly, cover your head and neck with pillows and blankets. Keep a stash of them next to you. Stay clear of the windows and doors, especially if you're in a glass building. Keep distance away from the glass. 11. Volcanic eruptions. A volcano is the opening of the Earth's crust, so it is the hub of all the molten rock, gases, and chemicals. Volcanoes are usually seen wherever Earth's tectonic plates converge or diverge. So majority of the volcanoes are sitting on our ocean beds right now. Whenever the pressure and density gets too high, Earth cools down by popping up a bottle of lava, which in turn becomes our natural disaster. So if you're traveling to a city with volcanoes around, how to save yourself? First, understand the community warning systems. An alarm could be going off in the area, indicating that a volcano is about to burst, and so you should be informed about every such signage. Always place all of your important documents and survival kit in one place. You should be able to vacate and leave immediately with all that you need. Avoid downstreams or downward areas. Remember to buy a safety mask to protect yourself from the chronic ash being released by the volcano. 10. Droughts. While droughts can last for weeks, months or even years, sometimes droughts are declared as soon as 15 days of shortage in water supply, both groundwater or surface water. The most prolonged drought lasted for over 400 years in Chile. Higher the temperatures go, warmer the earth gets, more chances of this calamity. One thing to note is that due to soil erosion after floods, usually a drought follows. So how to deal with it? There is not much to do while in drought except for conserving and using whatever water we have extremely cautiously. But before a drought hits, there is a lot one can do. For starters, make sure that there are no leakages anywhere. In piping, use water conservatively. Water plants with the used water during cooking instead of draining it all, and be more efficient with water usage. 9. Thunderstorms. If you think thunderstorms are not worthy of being on this list, think again. The lightning that thunders bring along can instantly kill people. Thunderstorms are also one of the primary reasons for flash flooding. Cumulonimbus clouds bring the thunderstorms accompanied with snow, hail, heavy rains, strong winds, and sometimes even tornadoes and water spouting. When the ground heats up due to high temperatures, warm air moves upwards and condenses into a cumulonimbus cloud. These deadly thunders sometimes also start off wildfires. So what to do? Stay indoors and avoid plugging into electrical outlets when it is thunderstorming heavily. During severe thunderstorms, avoid turning on taps to prevent electrocution. Stay as far as you can from trees, electricity poles or flagpoles. 8. Cold waves. Defined as a drastic fall of temperatures within 24 hours, forcing the need to protect agriculture, lives and a lot more. Particularly known to be hazardous to livestock and wildlife, human lives are at stake too when a cold wave hits very hard. The past 15 years have seen severe life loss due to cold waves preceded by intensely hot summers. So how to take care? Needless to say, stay warm and stay indoors. This is not the time to be experimenting outside or going viral. Once the cold wave starts, immediately stock up your water storage, because soon the water pipes and other plumbing would freeze or even break. Do not ignore any severe physical concerns like excessive bleeding or aches, and seek medical help immediately. 7. Heat waves. Heat waves have killed more than cold waves did. Any sudden rise in local temperatures than their limit can be referred to as a heat wave period. For instance, a 40 degrees in New Zealand could be considered as a heat wave period, though 40 is regular and common in India. It is basically the area not being accustomed to the kind of hot temperatures that are being clocked. So how to deal with it? First, it is important to note that heat waves not only result in physical stress, but also cause psychological and sociological stress. So it is important to take care of both your mind and body. Try and stay indoors as much as possible and increase the intake of liquids, especially water. When you're troubled with excessive body heat, cool your body by letting it sweat rather than indulging in air-conditioned life. Increase immunity and do not ignore any uncommon symptoms in the elderly or kids or people who are overweight. Consult a doctor immediately because they are the ones who are the most affected. 6. Wildfires. Wildfire is an unplanned fire that has the potential to burn down an entire forest or a grassland. One of the few natural disasters that could last days or even weeks, wildfires are often caused by lightning, human intervention, or just the extreme hot temperatures. Due to global warming and death of significant number of trees, these dead trees act as a fuel and spread these fires rapidly. So how to deal with this life-threatening calamity? If the authorities want you to evacuate, Evacuate! Do not second guess the seriousness. Wear the N95 masks without fail and get to an area which has lesser smoke. Listen to the weather reports and do not underestimate the severity. Do as you are told to do. 5. Floods. One of the most common natural disasters, floods occur when there is a temporary overflow of water onto a dry land. Flash floods, the worst kind, come with no warning. Flooding water is so powerful that only 6 inches of it can knock you out and 1 foot can sweep away vehicles. So what to do? As a precaution, if you are visiting or are living in a flood-prone area, always store your important documents in waterproof bags. If it is flooding, immediately move to the highest level of your building. Make sure that you do not hide in confined space. Do not try to swim, walk or drive through the flood water because the flood water is extremely powerful. Avoid driving on bridges and always listen in to a radio and monitor the situation. After flooding stops, be very cautious of snakes or other creatures that water may have brought into your house. Be mindful of electrocution risk. 4. Earthquakes. This disaster needs no introduction. One of the deadliest forms of natural calamities, massive earthquakes can result in tsunamis, landslides, and even volcanic eruptions. It is interesting to note that the shaking or splitting ground rarely causes life loss. It is the effects that follow, like man-made structure collapses or tsunamis or volcanic eruptions, that result in severe life loss. So what to do when the ground shakes? Basically, there is nothing you can do. But before it does, there is plenty that you can do which may end up saving lives. Number 1. Do not place weights over your sofas or beds. Build your home such that it reduces the damage and prevents life loss. At any given point, stock yourself with food and water that could last for at least a week. Aftershocks could be right around the corner, so take cover under a strong table until the ground stops shaking. Immediately look out for any gas leakages and take the safer exit. Never stand next to a building or any structure that could just fall on you. If you are inside, stay inside. Do not run out. If you are on bed, cover your neck and head with pillows and stay right there. If you are driving, reach a clear area and stop. Never use elevators and be extremely alert for any other natural disasters to follow, which is very common. Now, top 3. Cyclones, hurricanes and typhoons. Cyclones, typhoons and hurricanes refer to the exact same thing. If it develops in Atlantic or Northeast Pacific Ocean, a tropical cyclone is referred to as a hurricane. In Indian and South Pacific Ocean, it is a cyclone, and in Northwest Pacific, it is a typhoon. When ocean water warms up, thanks to global warming that is only on the rise, massive storms are formed and move towards the land. When the storm reaches land, that is what we call it making a landfall. So how to survive a hurricane? Thanks to technology, we can now know as soon as a storm forms in the ocean, and that gives us at least 24 to 36 hours of notice before the storm makes a landfall. During that window, it is important to make all necessary arrangements. Evacuate if the authorities tell you to do so. Constant updates are always provided across the media, TV, radio, social media, etc. Stock up all food and water supplies for at least a week and fuel your car with a tank full of gas. Make plans on where and how to keep your family safe when the eye of the storm passes you. Come up with communication plans that work for your family internally. Number 2. Tsunamis. Underwater earthquakes, landslides or volcanic eruptions cause massive waves in an ocean called tsunami. The infamous 2004 tsunami that caused deaths of over 230,000 across 14 nations actually was caused by a severe earthquake in the Indian Ocean. It is interesting to note that our science still hasn't developed enough to understand what kind of disturbance causes tsunami. Because some of the largest underwater earthquakes never cause tsunamis, while smaller earthquakes sometimes do. So what to do when waves of 10 to 100 feet high are chasing you? To prepare for such travesty, prepare a family emergency communication plan, a safe point to see each other if in case you get separated. When earthquakes, always look out for any warnings of tsunami. Do not wait, just evacuate immediately. Go to the higher grounds and wait if you cannot evacuate. If you are swept off by waters, do not try to swim against the current. Try to find something afloat and hold on to it. Never assume that the disaster has passed. There could be more aftershocks coming in. Be alert and be aware. Now, before we look at our number one pick, let's look at some special mentions. Sinkholes. Holes that form on the ground due to collapsing of the surface layer could be as deep as 2,000 feet. Blizzards. A severe snowstorm accompanied by strong winds that last for 3 hours or more. Hailstorms. A thunderstorm that brings along hails. Hails are those icy, frozen rain pellets. Ice storms. Winter storm that is accompanied by freezing rain. Now, number 1. Impact events. Let me put it this way. You do know the impact that nuclear bombs left on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, right? Imagine millions of such bombs bombarding the Earth at once. That's what a major impact event feels like. And a simple asteroid of just a few kilometers of radius can unearth this scale of massive destruction. Something similar is often cited as the reason for why the most powerful species that ruled the Earth for billions of years just disappeared overnight. Dinosaurs. While meteor showers are usually popcorn time for families, it is also a relief time for Earth, since that means all of them missed colliding the Earth. As much as I wish I could tell you what to do when an asteroid hits Earth, there is in fact nothing we could do, except for pray, hold on to our loved ones and relive some of our fondest memories as the asteroid approaches the Earth. Because in the end, it is all about love. The love that we spread and receive every day on this earth is far more precious than we really give it credit for. Because as you saw on this list, we never know what kind of a calamity knocks us out or when. If you found this video useful, please do subscribe. What would you do if an asteroid heads to Earth? Let me know in the comments below. Hoping for a tomorrow, Indianistic signing off.